God is able. God is able to do just what he said he would do. He's gonna fulfill. He's gonna fulfill every promise to you. Never give up on him. Don't give up on God, 'cause he won't give up on you. 'Cause he's able. Oh, sing with me. Oh, 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 he's able. He's able. Oh, 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 'cause he's able. He's able. He's able. He's able. Sing with me. 'Cause he's able. He's able. He's able. He's able. God is able. God is able to do just what he said he would do. He's gonna fulfill. He's gonna fulfill every promise to you. Never give up on him. Don't give up on God, 'cause he won't give up on you. 'Cause he's able. Oh, sing with me. Oh, 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 he's able. He's able. Oh, oh, oh. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, as we get ready to go into the Word of God and talk about fasting, help all of us to take the Word seriously. Minister to someone. Help them to see how effective it is to fast the way you ordained and designed for us to fast. Speak to your people through the Word of God. Get their attention. Someone who have been wondering why things haven't been changing, help them to get this Word. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Someone say a good amen right there. Glory to God. Listen to the Word of God. Now I'm talking about how to fast effectively. How to fast effectively. Listen, you got to understand, fasting, it's spiritual wisdom. Fasting is a tool that have been ordained by God himself. Man didn't come up with this. God came up with fasting. And I want you to pay attention to what he had to say about fasting in the book of Isaiah and also in the book of Matthew. You got to understand, some things in your life will not change unless you turn that plate upside down and fast for a period of time. I'm not going to tell you how long to fast. That's between you and God. Some of our bodies can handle it much longer than others. The length of time doesn't matter. It's you doing what you feel the Holy Spirit have put in your heart. Sometimes God begins to talk about fasting a whole lot and stir your remembrance up because you need to do a fast. You always can. And listen, whenever you are about to fast, have a purpose for your fast. Don't just say, oh, I'm fasting to be fasting. That's nonsense. Have a purpose for it. Every time Jesus fasted, he had a purpose for it. Every time Paul fasted, there was a purpose. Daniel, Elijah, Moses, all of the great men and women of God in the Bible, whenever they fast, they had a reason to fast. Esther, they fasted for a purpose. They wanted to see something done. And sometimes it just requires us turning our plates upside down and really zeroing in on what it is that we are believing God to do. Because fasting subdues the flesh. It gets you away from all the distractions. It causes our spirits to become much more in tune and sensitive to the voice and the leading of the Holy Ghost. Are you listening to me? We have fasted many different times and seen great results. We've done a half a day fast, a whole day fast, 3 day fast, 10 day fast, 5 day, 21, 40 days, 30 days, 31. It doesn't matter. What matters is you being led by the Holy Spirit to fast. Some of us may have to grow to the place where we can fast. you know, 5 days, 10 days, but don't just jump up and do it. You talk with your doctor. I'm not your doctor. Your doctor would know what you can handle and what you can't. Amen? It's all right to be wise. Let's take care of our bodies. Let's don't be so overzealous and do something stupid and bring harm to something that God have designed to be a blessing to our lives. Are you hearing me? So watch what Isaiah said about it in Isaiah chapter 58, verse 6. This is God talking. Is not this the fast that I have chosen? There is a fast that's chosen by God to loose the bands of wickedness. That's the person who is bound by sin. By you fasting and praying for that person and standing in the gap for them, whether it be yourself or family member, guess what? That person will be set free by the power of God to loose the bands of wickedness. What else it does? To undo heavy burdens. There are times when we have just been burdened down with the cares and the problems and the attacks of the enemy, and we went on a fast, and my God, it just felt like something broke and lifted from off of us. Are you hearing me? Glory to God. God, I'm talking about the anointing of the Holy Ghost is intensified operating through your life when you fast, which means to turn your plate down for a while. Some people do what you call a dry fast. They don't eat or drink. For me, I know God calls me to fast, but I drink water and I drink juice. I ain't trying to impress nobody. I'm trying to accomplish something between me and God. Hello, somebody. So he said, is not this the fast that I've chosen? To loose the bands of wickedness. It sets people free, whether they're on drugs, addicted to pornography, addicted to something crazy. The power of God can set them free. It might be pride, it just may be a gossiping, lying tongue, something. But the power of God can set them free from that bondage. To undo heavy burdens. My God, people are burdened down. You get on a fast and the Holy Ghost speaks to you. The Holy Ghost begin to wash you. The power and the presence of God is in operation much stronger in your life. Your worship is much more sweeter. The word of God comes more alive to you. Are you hearing me? My God, you drink up the presence of God on a fast because you become so much more sensitive. You become so much more aware of his presence, so much more alert. Glory to God. I feel an anointing right here. So he said, fasting, it loosed the bands of wickedness. People who are in bondage are set free. People who are burdened down, that burden is removed from off of them. Also, it says to let the oppressed go free. That's people who are spiritually oppressed by demons, always sad, always negative. Can't see the day, can't see the sunlight. I mean, no clouds out there. The sun is shining and they still look dark and gloomy. That's a spirit. That person is being tormented by a demon. They can't see the victory and nothing. Man, I want to get away from people like that. But you know what? You can't just avoid them. You got to fast and pray for those people because they need deliverance. And the Holy Ghost, God is saying, is not this the fast that I have chosen? To loose the bands of wickedness, to undo, to just undo, free a person up from their heavy burdens, and let the oppressed, they may be spiritually oppressed, it lets them go free, it sets them free, and that you break every yoke, that yoke of bondage, whatever yoke it is in a person's life, it may be in your own life. My God, the Bible says it breaks the yokes, it sets the captives free. You know, every time we go into a miracle service and we do a fast, however long God calls us to do, we see great results from that fast. Cancers dry up in those meetings after a fast. Are you hearing me? Demons are cast out. The blind see, the deaf hear, the cripples walk. People, bones are joined back together supernaturally. Heart disease, rheumatoid arthritis, tumors disappear out of people's bodies. Are you listening to me? Deaf and dumb people are set free by the power of God. That's the result of a fast, doing it God's way, not to be seen of men. We'll talk about that in a minute. This is between you and God. You're doing it for a godly purpose. Are you hearing me? You got to have a purpose in mind. Don't just fast to be fasting religiously to look spiritual. Who's got time for that nonsense? I'm not going to miss a meal over trying to impress you. I like my meals. Hello, somebody. I like me a good plate of food, and ain't nothing wrong with it. But you know, some people get stupid. They're trying to impress everybody. Man, ain't no one got time for it. We got too much demons to deal with. We got people to set free. We believe in God to bring an end time harvest in. Nobody's got time for those kind of games. Are you hearing me? Now watch what Jesus had to say about it. We're talking about how to fast effectively. Here's Jesus, Matthew chapter 6, verse 16 through 18. Moreover, Jesus said, when you fast, be not as the hypocrite of a sad countenance. You want everyone to feel sorry for you. Oh, he's not eating today. I feel so sorry for him. The devil is a liar. You ought to have a smile on your face. Amen. You should be feeling sorry for everyone else because they don't know God's about to give you a breakthrough. Are you listening to me? Jesus said, don't be as a hypocrite of a sad countenance and disfigure your face that you may appear unto men to fast. Verily I say unto you, they have their reward. People do these kind of stupid stuff. Jesus said, but you, when you fast, go shower, man. Go clean yourself up. Go shave. Go wash your face. Amen? Smell fresh. Smell extra good. Are you listening to me? Don't do stupid stuff, man. You know, people do that. Jesus said that thou appear not unto men to fast, but unto your Father which is in secret. That's why you're doing it. You're getting his attention. You're fasting. You're turning that plate down. It gets his attention. It says when you fast, you're doing it to your Father which is in secret. And your Father which sees in secret shall reward you openly. One of the greatest revelations on fasting is when the disciples could not cast the demon out of the little boy in Mark chapter 9. They came privately to Jesus saying, why could not we cast the devil out of that little boy? Because the demons in him tried to throw him into the fire and into the water. Jesus gave them an answer that revolutionized our life and ministry. Jesus said, however, this kind can only come out by prayer and fasting. So there are some things prayer alone cannot get the job done. There are some things it takes prayer and fasting. And you know, we don't hear much about it no more because people don't want to hear about fasting. People don't want to die to themselves. People want to hear easy gospel preached to them. No, Jesus said, if a man wants to follow me, he must first deny himself and take up his cross daily and follow me, or else you cannot be my disciple. Are you listening to me? So fasting is a way to turn the plate down. It's a way to deny your flesh and get with God. So we were talking today about how to fast effectively. How long you do it, it's between you and God, and it ain't nobody's business. And Jesus said, your Father who sees what you are doing in secret, because that's what really counts. You want to get his attention. Your Father who sees what you're doing in secret will reward you openly. Father God, I thank you for ministering to your people. Thank you for speaking to them. Thank you for encouraging them. Let God do a work in their lives as they fast and pray. Let them see results. Let them see answers. Let them see the captives set free and the devil put on the run. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Someone say, amen. I want to give you an opportunity right now to support the work of the ministry, to support the preaching and teaching of the gospel and the word that we are doing. And to do so, you can visit us online right now. seanpinderministries.net/give. seanpinderministries.net/give. You can also give through the ministry PayPal account. That address is paypal.me/SeanPinderMinistries. paypal.me/SeanPinderMinistries. You can also give through the Cash App. The ministry Cash App account is $SeanPinderMinistries. $SeanPinderMinistries. You can also give by mailing your donations, offerings, and love gifts to the ministry. Just remember to make your checks and money orders out to Sean Pinder Ministries, P.O. Box 2726, McKinney, Texas 75070. And never forget, me and my lovely wife, Pastor Aimee, we love you, we care about you, and we don't take what you're doing for granted. The seeds that you are sowing into God's kingdom, He is going to bless you. He's going to honor you because of your faithfulness. You're doing it for His sake and the gospel. And Jesus said, that's how you get 100-fold. It will come back to you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over, shall men give into your bosom. God bless all of you. We love you. We'll see you again on tomorrow morning for another morning prayer broadcast. We love you. God bless you. Take care now. Bye-bye.